body we found in the garden was Mukuro. That's one thing we can be sure of.
I need to remember that you just gotta, regardless of if you're ahead of the game or whatever and you're thinking about certain stuff, you've just gotta, you gotta shoot at the things that properly actually contradict what's actually written there, rather than trying to pull some like argument out of like part of the evidence that will be used, but like, you know what I mean. Stop thinking of some kind of elaborate explanation as to why you can, just be simple. That's what I need to be.
The body's appearance and measurements are consistent with her records. Right, Kyoko?
She was 5'6" tall and weighed 97 pounds. Her vitals were 31, 21, 32.
Is this Junko's? Because isn't Makoto's 31, 22? I'm 5'7". Yeah.
Everything in her profile is consistent with that corpse.
You just okay.
And there's the matter of the Fenrir tattoo. So there's no question it's her.
But if Yukuro's not the mastermind, then
so it's an idiot. It's obviously Junko. Someone's made it look like they died, but they're still actually alive. There's only one person it could be.
Here's my answer. Junko is still alive. It's the only possibility.
Are you sure about that?
Huh?
I admit, since Mukuro is undoubtedly dead, Junko does seem to be the only other explanation.
Mm-hmm.
But we saw her get impaled. She died right before our very eyes. If Junko were still alive, the death we saw would had to have been some kind of charade.
Mm-hmm.
But you yourself confirmed she was dead, did you not?
Now you mention it. I gently placed my hand on Junko's lifeless body. I touched her wrist to check for a pulse, but then... Mm-hmm. I need to remember to read.
So, the idea that she's still alive.
Nah, she's dead. No. The twins, fam.
Then you're withdrawing your previous statement?
I know you gave it your best shot, but too bad. I guess your conclusion was a dud.
No, dude.
Too bad.
Come on, Makoto, you can prove it.
Decided just yet. You haven't given up already, have you, Makoto?
Huh?
No, of course not. There's no way I'd give up that easy.
That's all well and good, but how do you intend to solve the problem standing in your way? Junko absolutely died. Mukuro absolutely died.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them are dead, right? There can't be any kind of survivor story.
I think we need to look at this from the opposite direction.
Huh? Mm-hmm.
The opposite direction? Let's assume Junko is still alive. If so, how could she have survived?
How could Junko have survived? I checked her, she was dead, I'm sure of it. But still, if she were alive somehow, could it be that Junko's not the one that died? Wasn't Junko, but someone else entirely? Maybe she used some sort of trick. Mm-hmm. Makeup? Is that the word? What word is this? What word is this? P and a C, 8-letter word. I wouldn't, not doppelganger. Love you too, man. Someone begins telling me that the word begins with an S. So I'll just wait for it. Mal, can you give me some words, please? No. TLCDAP. Let's go with R. Oh, okay. E? Replica as, give me an eye. No? E? Maybe an A? Replace. Give me an E, man. Oh, replaced. Okay. Replaces. I don't know why I thought of that. Replace. Okay. That was.
That's it. What if she switched places with someone else?
Oh, I didn't even look. I didn't even look at the chat, to be honest. I just asked you that, and I was like, just start guessing. Lol. Replicate. I thought it was also replicate, but. Goodbye, TJ.
That's right. Before the
good luck in the game.
She got someone to take her place. Specifically, Mukuro Ikusaba.
Then that would make it Mukuro's corpse that showed up later.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why the body's height and weight and everything match Mukuro's profile, right?
Yes.
I don't know anything about this switching places thing, but that had to be Junko who got stabbed to death, right?
Yeah, you're saying they switched? When could they even have done that?
The start.
Right when she was about to die? Like she used some kind of ninja replacement technique? Good point. There's just no way they could have switched like that. Maybe the whole idea is wrong.
No. Has to be some way. I have to figure the switch at the beginning.
Two of them may have switched places from the very beginning.
What? From the beginning?
Yes, from the moment we first met. If that's when they switch. Then they wouldn't have had to switch at the moment of death, right? After all, the one we saw at that point would have already been Mukuro.
But hold on. So you're saying the Junko we first met was actually Mukuro all along?
Then we'd already met her? I had like a normal conversation with her.
Mm-hmm.
When we first met, none of us knew who anyone else was. So Mukuro could have simply told us her name was Junko, and we never would have known the difference.
Yep.
That would easily allow the two of them to switch places from the very beginning.
Wait, but Mukuro had a tattoo on the back of her hand, right? Junko never had any tattoo like that, did she?
She could have hidden it with foundation or something like that.
Hello, Adil. I'm finishing off this game.
If she did, it likely melted away in the explosion. exposing the tattoo after the body was extinguished. Plus, there were the fake nails found on the hands of Mukuro's body.
I just wanted to finish off the game.
They were the same fake red nails she was wearing when we all met for the first time.
But if she really did use foundation?
Correct. Even if there was no tattoo on her hand, I couldn't say for certain it wasn't Mukuro. So I'm glad nobody noticed that glaring hole when we were trying to figure out who attacked Makoto.
Mm-hmm.
Too bad for you, Monokuma. You can't deny it anymore.
Wait, so this whole thing was a setup from the very beginning?
Yeah.
If that's true, it was quite an elaborate plan to be sure, making it look like Mukuro was Junko.
The reason such an elaborate plan was possible is because the two of them were working together.
So Mukuro, the ultimate despair, teamed up with someone like her. In other words, it would be fair to say that Junko herself was also the ultimate despair.
What's wrong? Lost the will to fight back?
I think he's just afraid.
Afraid? What's that mean, afraid? Fear is only possible where hope is possible. I only have despair, so fear is an alien concept to me.
And why haven't you been saying anything?
Because it's a bunch of nonsense. Junko's my secret identity. As if.
Then why did you try and protect Junko's real identity?
I tried to protect her identity. When did I do that?
So he still refuses to admit it, but he can try to deceive us all he wants. It doesn't matter, because I've already figured it out. He tried to hide Junko's identity not once, not just once, but twice. The first time was during our latest investigation. Yes. Okay, and I don't think this is. Oh. Maybe was this one? Oh, no, not that. Was it because did he take it? No, guys, I'm actually lost. I'm flipping lost. Is it this? Yes. No. Fuck. Give it another shot, let's go. You know, I just did that so I could get rid of my hearts, so I could get back up to full. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying, you know. You know what I'm saying? I was just resetting. Oh. It doesn't matter, I'm okay. Everyone makes mistakes. Okay, so it's not that. I'm gonna present this one, but let me look at everything else again. I just wanted to, Yeah. What the fuck? Then what is it, Makoto? Nope. Had to hide Junko's identity, not once but twice. The first was during Junko's identity. Junko. Mukuro. Identity's not that one. Okay, that's not it either. It wasn't this. Biolab. Biolab, no. Wasn't that either. Not that. Junko's identity, that one, that doesn't relate. Emergency handbook, doesn't relate. Yasuhiro, doesn't relate. That, does not relate. Does not relate, does not relate. It'd have to be this one. What the hell? Why did you? Okay. Does not relate. Maybe? Oh yeah. Ha 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 ha. I forgot about that one.
Watching the DVD of our interviews with the headmaster.
You made sure I couldn't finish watching the video. And the reason you did that.
Class photo. Yeah, you kid.
Real Junko, did you?
Oh, yeah. If everyone was in that video, of course Junko would have had to show up.
And if Makoto saw the real Junko, it would have been totally obvious that the Junko we met was an imposter.
But that whole power outage thing was just a fluke.
No, it wasn't just a fluke. The mastermind definitely orchestrated that power outage. And that's not the only time they tried to hide Junko's identity. The mastermind tried to cover up one other piece of evidence. I gotta reveal that. Don't do this again. No. No. Oh my gosh.
Punishment is waiting for you. I'm not listening. What are you even talking about?
There we go.
The video wasn't the only thing you tried to cover up. You did the same thing with this group photo. I noticed it just a little while ago when we were all comparing the photos we'd gotten. In all the photos, there's a certain similarity, an unusual circumstance.
What's so unusual about them?
Unusual circumstance. Common to all these pictures.
I got it! Junko's face. The one thing common to every single photo is that you can't see her face. It's hard to believe her face would just happen to be hidden in every single picture, don't you think? And on top of that,
In this photo, you can see that Mukuro is clearly visible. So in other words, at that point, the two of them hadn't switched yet. With all that in mind, there's no doubt that the girl whose face is hidden here is the real Jun.
What's up, Hatim? Why are you still awake?
Which is why you had to have pictures that didn't show her face.
I don't play League anymore.
Because if we could have seen her
stopped
face,
a long time ago.
It would have clearly revealed that the Junko in the pictures wasn't the Junko that we knew. Xanadu!
I believe everything Makoto said is true. Junko and Mukuro switched places before we met either of them.
Same as even Pan's terrible too.
So she killed Mukuro, who had taken her place, making it look like she died. And the real Junko is still alive.
And she's the one behind this whole murderous situation. This killing game. She's the true mastermind. And the ultimate despair.
Mm-hmm.
With this, the identity and the crimes of the mastermind have been exposed.
No, wait, hold on. Don't bother trying to deny it. There's no more room for debate. You don't have anywhere left to run.
Yes, Makoto, here we go. Big Mac is coming through. Look at him, look how assertive he is. He's grown.
I'll prove everything right now.
Yes, Makoto, tell him, Nayagi. Oh, I should stop. I shouldn't make noise. Alright, so let's see. This is from the beginning of the game when they met. Okay, so. What the hell? This? Okay. Act 2. She steps on him, gets stabbed, and she dies. Act 3. Oh, I didn't have to do anything in Act 2, huh? Alright, then Act 3. Let's see. Yes. And she takes out Mukuro. Yeah, and she lays out on the floor. Okay. Let's see. That one. And then this. Nope, it's not that. No, sorry, this should be that. No. Oh, this one? I am confused. I am very confused. Okay, I know for a fact that this one's this. Sorry, wrong one. Boom, is like all according to Keikaku. All according to plan. Now the one we need to figure out is this. Boom. Did he really have the did his heart really skip a beat when he saw her? Damn.
But that wasn't the real Junko.
Nope.
The girl we saw before us was actually the 16th student who had taken Junko's place.
Looks like Junko on her stand.
And that menacing. Girl's name was Mukuro. She died at the hands of Monokuma. In other words, the mastermind, Junko and Oshima. Her body was kept in a biolab, which had been converted into a morgue, until Junko decided to put her body to use.
Mm-hmm.
Junko dragged the body out of the biolab, using the tarp to carry her to the garden. She fabricated the murder to try and frame Kyoko, who'd proven to be one big thorn in her side. Meanwhile, she wanted us all to think Mukuro was still alive and hiding somewhere inside the school.
I thought maybe that's when she'd seen the white thing go into his room, but... I can't think of anything different. What else could it be? What the hell is that? Because it's not... This panel is here. It's not the furnace. Oh, I see. Is... Is that already in this room? Must be. I'm just gonna it's the only way I can think of it. Okay. No way! I have to. I didn't know I had lives on that one. All right, let me try again. Telling me the closing interface is so hard. Sometimes, especially once it loads like this, it's so confusing. Like some of the panels just aren't clear. Not clear enough anyway. Although I do like it. Alright, so this one's this. And then this one's gotta be this. Oh no, yeah, I do. I don't like how many times I've lost during this last... during this last case, but... hey ho, what can you do? Wish I could have done it flawlessly.
The killer is you!
The killer is you! The stand. Okay.
She wanted us to believe the murder had only recently taken place. Finally, by strapping a bomb to the body, she was able to destroy any remaining evidence.
Mm-hmm.
She needed to hide the body's true identity.
Indeed.
She had to make sure we didn't find out it was actually the same person we'd met in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
This is the truth behind Mukuro's murder. And the one who carried it all out is the true mastermind. The one controlling Monokuma. The real Junko Enoshima.
Monokuma and his standoff. Mastermind.
That's the whole story behind this incident. Well, what do you have to say to that?
Bring her out already. Bring her out already.
So don't even try.
Come on. Mm-hmm. It's time you finally revealed yourself.
Show yourself.
It's not like you're an endangered species or something. Keep hiding.
She's just making her way down here.
Give it up, Junko. The game's over.
Over? Did you really think the story would end once we reach the climax of the case? Wrong! There's still plenty more to go!
Using her ninja technique. Ultimate Despair, Junko Enoshima.
We have been waiting, waiting so very long for peasants like you to appear.
I don't like her voice. I don't think that suits her. Maybe I'll put the game in Japanese.
If you swear your fealty to us, we will reward you with half of the entire world. We've even drawn up the deed already. We will grant you honor, status, and some of our home cooking. Have you made your choice? Will you serve under us?
Okay. If I could save now, I'd see which ones it does.
Oh,
no, thanks.
Did you think I was being serious?
Oh, there we go.
Sorry. I was just messing with you.
That makes... yeah, I just realized that, Mel. This makes all sense to be her voice.
It's been so long since I've had an audience. Even I'm not sure what kind of role I'm supposed to play.
This is a mastermind? She's the real Junko Enoshima.
Anyway, looks like I've finally been set free. Having to play Monokuma all the time, day after day. It was like I was stuck in purgatory. Or... like a slow suicide. I get bored so easy, you know?
When she said suicide, she sounded a bit like a robot.
Face. Huh? What about my face? What's wrong with my beautiful face? People have told me I'm cuter than 100 chihuahuas combined.
They've really got the despair thing down to a point. She doesn't have freckles either. Junko 70 mask, it would have been the same, I know.
I feel like this isn't the first time I've seen it.
No, I do remember seeing it. I'm sure I've seen that too somewhere. Where was it? What the hell? No, that's not correct. That's not correct either, so it has to be this. No, never mind. I don't know. Oh, yeah, actually. He saw it in the magazines, my bad.
It was before I ever came to this school. I remember seeing the magazine cover. And you were on it.
Wow, you have a pretty good memory. I guess that's why you've made it this far, huh?
So I was right. Then what you told me in the main hall when this all began...
Sometimes a little lie is necessary to keep things moving along. Wouldn't you agree?
I really like her voice actor. Her voice acting, it's really good.
That explains why she didn't quite seem the same. Because she was a different person all along.
I'm me. And Mukuro is Mukuro. She tried her best. But there's just no way she could have passed as the ultimate fashionista. Two people can never become one as long as the walls of mind and body exist. Not even if they're twins.
Twins!
It's true.
I know. It's such a cliche, right? I'm almost embarrassed to admit it. So basically, Mukuro and I had your stereotypical twin relationship. The older sister, tough and proud. That was Mukuro. The younger sister, smart and cute. That was...
Me! Junko fucking Enoshima!
I liked her older voice. Her previous personality.
And together, we were the Despair Sisters! AKA the Ultimate Despair!
She's a totally different person now!
Like I said, I get bored easy as hell! I even get fucking bored with myself!
But if you're twins... Why do you have different last names?
Oh, that again? You have any idea how many times people ask me that shit? Maybe it's new to your dumb ass, but it forced me to tears. Answering the same questions over and over? Just make up whatever answer you want. I don't give a shit. The truth's fucking lame anyway.
But if she was your twin, that means you killed your own sister?
In cold blood.
And for reasons deeper and darker than the ocean.
Well, I suppose I'd better explain. For my plan to work, someone had to be able to control the killing game from behind the scenes. The so-called mastermind had to operate Monokuma, keep an eye on everyone, things like that. But after looking at the situation, I determined it would be impossible for Mukuro to perform such duties. Because naturally, she turned out to be the letdown of the family. Leaving me behind to run off and join some band of mercenaries. Such a disappointment. So, I decided to play the role of director and have her join the rest of you in your school life. I could have let her work alongside me, but she would have been useless to me that way. Besides, 15 students seemed like a solid number to start with. Of course, the fact that she was the ultimate soldier posed something of a problem. She had what I call the three atrocities. Atrociously rank, atrociously filthy, atrociously repulsive.
Oof.
It was atrociously clear just how out of touch she was with the rest of society. Meanwhile, my ultimate fashionista status has an undeniable appeal that I didn't want to go to waste.
And that's why you switched identities?
Sadly, Her inability to match my personality was even greater than I'd calculated. It was a lost cause. She was nothing more than a bit player, an extra, unworthy of lines. Being the utter disappointment that she was, anyone would have expected her to get killed off right away. Which is precisely why I killed her. To meet everyone's expectations.
That can't be your only reason, can it?
Well, no, of course not. I also did it to avoid becoming bored.
I've never been a stickler for following a plan to the letter, you know?
Oh my gosh.
If I planned everything out and knew just what was gonna happen, that'd be so boring. So, I changed things just a bit and decided to use Mukuro to make a little point.
In other words, Mukuro's death was a one-sided, premeditated act of betrayal, just as I suspected. When Mukuro was killed, she must have been as surprised as anybody else.
What? Huh?
So, you figured it out? Well, you're right! There's no way Mukuro could have pulled off such a convincing performance! But she did teach you all a very valuable lesson, don't you think?
How can you talk like that?
Mm-hmm.
You sacrificed your own sister. How does that not even bother you?
What? I sacrificed her? That's what's got you so hot under the collar? Jeez, misunderstandings sure are scary. We were the ultimate despair.
She needs to die.
Think anything of it?
That's not true at all.
She's the ultimate despair. She does things to feel despair.